We will demonstrate the placement of an epicelial talus in the left ankle. The patient is in the supine position and we operate in a bloodless field. The contour of the medial malleolus is marked on the skin and we start by an anterior arthrotomy with excision of the anterior capsule. We place a Holmann retractor in order to protect the anterior structures. And what we can also do is to place a small sharp Holmann retractor into the distal tibia. This will make it necessary for an assistant to hold it. Opening the retinaculum for the posterior tibial tendon and then with blunt dissection with this large size blunt instrument, we go into the direction of the ostrigonum and then we can place a Holmann to protect the neurovascular structures at the back of the joint. Then we place the osteotomy guide, the patient-specific osteotomy guide, and we make sure that it fits onto the periosteum of the distal tibia, and we secure it with two 2mm K-wires. Then we pre-drill the two holes for the screws, which we will later on use to secure the medial malleolus osteotomy, and typically these are 2.5 millimeter drill holes. The depth of the osteotomy, we checked it with the osteotomy depth meter, and then we protect the neurovascular bundles in the front and at the back, and then we use the osteotome, especially in the front and at the back, very careful not to go through the cartilage to finish the osteotomy. After finishing the osteotomy, we can flip the medial malleolus. We use a large osteotome initially, and then with the two thumbs, you will see that we can dislocate it. Then we will place two K-wires, place it away from the operating field in order not to interfere later on with the drilling. We place them for the Hintermann distractor. And you will see when we open the Hintermann distractor that we have good access to the talus. It helps to do a release of the posterior capsule in order to have more opening of the joint. Then we will place the AP guide. There's only one position in which we can place the AP guide. Make sure the AP guide is flush with the cartilage surface and then we secure it with two K-wires. The pin socket with a 2mm K-wire to drill a central hole which will accommodate the drill which we will later on introduce through this drilling socket. Check that the socket has bottomed onto the AP guide and then we will drill it. Use a lavage to take away any debris. And then the second step is the adjustment socket with the starting position, as is shown, the starting position, which will mean that the AP sealer will be flush with the cartilage if we would place it later on in this position. But this is how we start. Again, make sure the guide is, the drill is flush with the surface. And then we place the AP dummy. Check the marking on the AP dummy. It has to fit like this. And then we will check the position, the surface of the AP dummy, and it should be now flush with the cartilage, anterior, posterior, medial, and lateral. And then we can have a 0.2, a 0.4, or 0.6 millimeter depth in relation to the cartilage. In this case, we choose a 0.6. We place it, we drill it again, flush it in order to take away the debris. Check if with the AP dummy, if we are satisfied or if we have to go another 0.2 millimeter lower. In this case, we are happy. So we mark on the skin the rotation. And here you see that we marked, not on the skin, on the cartilage, the rotation. And after removal of the AP guide, we can now place the AP sealer. Make sure the rotation mark is aligned with the marking on the cartilage, and then by hand we can gently push it in, and finally with the AP mandrill we can secure it to its final position. Check if there is a 0.6 millimeter in this case position below the surface of the cartilage, and when we are happy, then we can close the osteotomy with some initial compression like this. We placed initially 2.5 millimeter K wires through the holes to secure the position, and exchange it now for two 3.5 millimeter compression screws. 3.5 millimeter compression shoes, screws with short windings in order to secure the compression. And then we will close the subcutaneous layer, and in the end we will close the skin with nylon sutures.